This is Robert Ian with GoldSeek.com Radio. There's a whole lot of talk across all communication channels about protecting the integrity of democracy. By protecting the integrity of our elections. There's a lot of verbal smoke on this subject, but no easily explained underlying evidence to support the supposed interference into our elections. Rewind to the 2000 presidential election between George Bush Jr. and Al Gore. It was a close election that was eventually decided by the U.S. Supreme Court. There was a whole lot of ballyhoo at the time about the ineffectiveness of paper ballots, a problem, by the way, that did not exist before that election, and was attributed to the, quote, hanging Chad issue, which was supposedly the result of voters not knowing how to use simple punch cards, thereby blaming the voter and creating a bizarre rationale to begin introducing electronic voting machines, which, by the way, can be hacked. There are numerous videos and investigative reports on the web showing the relative simplicity of this process. Assume for a moment that of those voting districts that use electronic balloting, that do not have paper backups, which is about 25%, and that somehow some portion of those were hacked, it would be not by a foreign entity, but in person, on an individual basis in each precinct, namely because voting machines are not connected to the internet. The system is heavily decentralized. A lengthy October 19, 2016 article on, you guessed it, CNN, proclaimed that no, the presidential election can't be hacked. It's a very thorough article that even mentions the specter of Russian interference, which was laid to rest ahead of the election. Remember, this article and many others like it appeared 3 weeks before the 2016 presidential election, when every major news outlet was absolutely certain Hillary Clinton would win the presidency. You'll recall it was Donald Trump suggesting at his rallies that the elections might be rigged against him, not by some foreign entity, but by his opponent and her surrogates. These numerous articles about the decentralization of the presidential election were designed to counter President Trump's assertions of possible rigging against him. In that article, Nicholas Weaver, a computer scientist and cybersecurity expert at the International Computer Institute at the University of California, Berkeley, said the following: nobody is going to be able to change the outcome of the presidential vote by hacking voting machines. The system is too distributed, too decentralized, too many implementations for any individual actor or group to make substantial change. Yes, they're horribly insecure. Yes, many of them give me nightmares, Mr. Weaver stated, but the attackers are not going to be able to change the outcome of the presidential vote that way. How come the media isn't referring back to its previously quoted experts? Because a close and thoughtful examination of the pre-election narrative indicating the presidential election can't be hacked, compared with the media's never-ending post-election narrative of innuendo and generalized allegations, suggests just one thing. Both narratives cannot be true, especially in the absence of evidence. Which means the media, and its political surrogates were lying, or shall we say misrepresenting the truth before the election, or they are lying and misrepresenting the truth now after the election. Regardless of which is true, the media has misrepresented a situation for political gain, at the expense of integrity and confidence in our election system. A return to strictly paper ballots for presidential elections is likely the only solution that will restore some semblance of confidence to a system that seemed to be doing just fine prior to the 2000 presidential election and has been on a downward slope ever since. And until next time, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com, reminding you to follow us on Twitter at ConquerChange. Thanks, Chris.
Okay, Robert, thanks for another excellent installment. Well, that wraps up this week's GoldSeek.com radio episode. For two new big guests, be sure to check out next week's show. Until we talk to you again, have a great week.